The Baltimore Child Abuse Center is a resource for children who are victims of child abuse and their caretakers. BCAC helps investigate cases of child abuse, provides treatment for victims, and also provides education to help recognize and prevent child abuse in the community. Nationally recognized as one of the leading advocates of children in the country, over the last few years, they have partnered with Lifebridge Health to create the Center for Hope. Executive Director of the Center, Adam Rosenberg, joins me to talk about the center and how you can get involved. Good morning, Adam. Welcome back to Maryland Perspectives.
Thanks, Amelia. Great to have the time to spend with you today.
So let's talk about the Lifebridge Health partnership. How did it come about?
For about 10 years now, we've been working closely with partners within Lifebridge Health, and especially their CEO, Neil Meltzer, who takes a true public health perspective to ending and preventing violence there. And Neil and his team at Lifebridge really appreciated what we were doing at Baltimore Child Abuse Center, and we started to build partnerships in our programs, funding our medical program, funding some of our research. And ultimately, as we were looking at both of our growth trajectories, and recognizing that we have a real role to play in keeping the community safe and preventing violence from occurring, which then leads people into hospitals and lifelong ailments and illnesses due to adverse childhood experiences, Lifebridge said, why don't you join the family? And that's when we created the Center for Hope. And so Baltimore Child Abuse Center, along with other Lifebridge Health violence programs, such as our Dove Domestic Violence Intervention Program, our Safe Street site in Belvedere, our hospital violence intervention teams at Sinai and Grace, all roll up in this new Center for Hope. Slowly, we're going to be phasing out the Baltimore Child Abuse Center name, which was really our program only focusing on child abuse, and we're promoting our Center for Hope as the new brand and the new image for our comprehensive response to violence from birth through old age, having teams and experts, medical experts, psychologists, therapists, advocates, all available to help respond to child abuse, human trafficking, domestic violence, community violence, and elder abuse, really finding new innovative solutions to do that. And perhaps most exciting with this, Amelia, is we're going to be building a new headquarters as well. And so part of our work with Lifebridge is to not only create a new programmatic Center for Hope, but also a new physical Center for Hope. And so we'll be leaving our location in Old Goucher and opening up a brand new state-of-the-art 32,000 square foot building in March 2022 on Sinai's expanded campus next to the Preakness Track, which we couldn't be more excited about, to have a space that is open for all survivors of violence, but even more so as a resource for people to prevent violence from occurring in their community to begin with.
Oh, it is. I'm excited for you because I have been to the center in downtown Baltimore, which it's going to be nice to welcome the families in there and the children, especially in a brand new space. It's just, I know what it's like to walk into a new house, right?
Yeah.
If you buy a new house,
right.
You're like, oh my gosh, I could do so much. And it's just a brand new footprint, which is, I'm so excited for you too, Adam. That's great.
And what's been fun for us too is to design this from the ground up. We looked at the best programs in the country and the best models to say what needs to work for our program here. And so we've designed the space to be trauma-informed and child-friendly and victim-supportive, so that we've got private waiting rooms, we've got 14 therapeutic suites, we've got 3 medical offices, we've got the resources and the space available to be able to really treat and help and heal the community. And we're not doing it with them. We intentionally called ourselves Center for Hope, that it's not our job to give people hope, but we work with them to help reactivate and reignite hope there. And that this space will be that physical manifestation of it there. And so it's really exciting to look at what we love about the existing building in the city and replicate that in a brand new state-of-the-art space.
Well, and once again, you're going to be leading the way for the entire nation so that when other states look at what you've done, hopefully that will pass on to other states where more of these facilities can be built. And I'm glad you brought up the violence aspect. Obviously, here in Baltimore, we hear about it all the time. We've seen an uptick during the pandemic. We are surpassing last year's 300 total homicides. And we talk about the blood. We talk about the people who are shooting each other, but we don't talk about the children who witness these events and they see this violence firsthand. So what is the Center for Hope going to do for these types of children? And how is Lifebridge Health try to heal people from post-traumatic stress?
Yeah, you know, Lifebridge has given us that platform and that ability to magnify and amplify our message there. Over the last several years, we recognized that there were a great many number of children who were impacted by other violences and traumas besides child abuse who deserved and needed help. a biggest part of that are children who've witnessed, who've survived homicide. For every child homicide that there is, Amelia, there's a blast radius of about 10 to 12 kids who are also impacted by that homicide there, the siblings of, the witnesses to, the friends of that deceased child. And stemming from work that is almost, you know, 10, 12 years old now from Attorney General Holder during the Obama years, there was a fascinating work group called the Defending Childhood Initiative, which focused on children exposed to violence. And they were having the same impacts and outcomes as kids who'd been victim of child abuse. And so we made it as a part of our mission over the last several years to be able to respond to children who've been impacted by homicide, having counselors and therapists and case managers available to help those children and their caregivers help those kids get past that trauma there. Kids can't just walk this stuff off. And when we're living in a city that has experienced not only over 300 homicides, but shockingly 16, 17 child homicides this year due to gun violence and child abuse, we need to do something about it. One of the ways that Lifebridge has helped us there is giving us that bigger platform. And back in May, we launched our Red Desk project. You can go to reddesk.org and learn more about it. And we obtained 116 desks from the Baltimore City school system and painted them red to signify all the children that had been murdered in Baltimore City over the last 6 years, a 33% increase from the previous time period there. And we displayed them all on the front lawn of Sinai Hospital, which it was such a stark reminder for anyone who drove past that corner that these are 116 lives that have been lost that should be sitting in school desks in a school and instead are displayed and empty on the front lawn. And I think it's those things that allow us to really make that message available and then make the resources available. You're right. No one else is doing this in the country. This is really the first of its kind program that is a comprehensive violence intervention program that's also working with the health system. And I'm really proud that Lifebridge took the opportunity to help us grow here.
The best way to stop this from happening, we can shock with these red desks, and I think that's a great idea. But how is the Center for Help intervening to try and break the cycle of violence before these events even happen?
Certainly one way is in the aftermath of a homicide is not letting these survivors of violence suffer. And so for the 16 murders we've had this year, there are probably 160 to 200 kids who've also been impacted by it. And so it's making sure that those kids get the resources and the support that they need from their schools, from their loved ones, to be able to make sure that they don't become victims of violence or perpetrators of violence in the future. That breaks the cycle of violence there. But certainly we all want to be able to prevent that from happening in the first place.
Right.
And that's one of the reasons that we incorporated a Safe Streets program into our Center for Hope. One of the things that makes Center for Hope unique is that it is not just a program focusing on intrapersonal violence between family members and relatives and child abuse and domestic violence, but we're adding in that community violence aspect to it as well, and that hospital violence intervention aspect, so that when violence occurs, we're using the nationally accepted cure violence model to have violence interruption take place there, and breaking that cycle of violence by working with trusted community leaders to prevent violence from happening in the first place, also working with organizations to give them the policies and the training and the resources that they need to build a better organization so that incidents of violence and abuse don't happen there, and that when they do, they know how to respond properly.
Right. I could see partnerships with, say, Living Classrooms, their Safe Streets program. I've talked to them a lot about what they're trying to do to go into that community and actually use the people that live in those communities to be the outreach so that they're seeing their neighbor come and talk to them. They're seeing their neighbor trying to intervene.
Yeah.
With these violence.
You know, one of the things we've been able to do here is we have critical mass. By having a large program like this, we've always done partnership really well as Baltimore Child Abuse Center. It is the touchstone of our work, that we don't do this by ourselves. We work with police and prosecutors and social services and communities. And by having a larger Center for Hope, it gives us the chance to work with programs like Safe Streets and Living Classrooms and the Family Tree, right, and Turnaround and all sorts of organizations who are also doing great work. We don't aspire to be the one who does all the work, but we know that we can be, again, that center to be able to pull people together and to come up with collaborative solutions and help each of us do our best work there.
That's fantastic. You're sort of like a community center of health, where all of these all these nonprofits can come together, meet in one place, and go, "Oh, you're doing this? Well, we can help you with that. You're doing
and
this.
Let's be a community and perhaps be a community center for hope." And we've got that space that we can collaborate and meet and come
Love
up with
it.
Solutions. We don't profess to have all the answers,
right,
but we want to be able to work with people you know, to come up with the best answers for them and their community based on the best practices and the best knowledge we have available.
I cannot recommend your website enough. It's a great way to get tips on how to spot child abuse, to maybe neglect. If you see one of your neighbor kids, maybe, you know, they're never washed. Maybe I saw a child like that the other day, and you're thinking to yourself, you know, do I get involved? Do I make a phone call? And who do I call? And your website has all of that information. So for 98 Rock listeners, obviously we'll give the website where they can go and get some more information, but how can we help you further the mission of not only, you know, child abuse, stopping child abuse, but also stopping the violence?
I think having these conversations on a regular basis, and anytime you want me to come in and spin records with you, Amelia, I'm happy to do that. And we can talk about it between tracks. But directing people to go to lifebridgehealth.org/hope is one great way to begin to have the conversation and have the tools out there. It's scary to have to pick up the phone and report abuse. And I think a lot of what we've regrettably seen in the last year of these child fatalities, these child murders, are people who said they heard something, they saw something, they suspected something, and they didn't do something. It's that indifference or that inaction that perpetuates violence. It's about getting involved. And so I think if people have questions, they can certainly visit our website. They can call our HOPE line, 410-601-HOPE. To try and get some answers there. And some other ways 98 Rock listeners can help is, of course, by making a donation. And you can do that as well at lifebridgehealth.org/hope. I mean, we need funds to keep this mission running here. We accept donations of not just money, but clothing and toiletries. And we have a whole Amazon wish list for what our families need. And I think one of the other ways people can help is let's pay attention to the legislative process. Let's make sure that our elected leaders in Annapolis and the city of Baltimore are focusing on some of these issues there. And when we have the chance to have our elected officials' ears to ask them, well, what are you doing to keep children safe? What are you doing to keep victims from domestic violence from becoming victims again? I think the other great way that 98 Rock can help is just encouraging listeners to get involved and to, you know, by exposing them to organizations like us is really great. So really appreciate the fact that we can have this conversation, share the website, speak to people, because this is an issue that affects all of us, whether you live in Baltimore City or not, that it's affecting everyone wherever we are.
Right. And violence and child abuse is happening everywhere. Adam Rosenberg is the executive director of the Center for Hope at Lifebridge Health. And I'll make sure I get the links up on our website. Thank you so much for all you and your staff do to advocate for children in Maryland. It really is amazing.
Oh, my pleasure. Thanks for the time today.